chitosan and its role in plant disease management. The following are the subject matters that will be discussed in the following presentation. Introduction, chitin, chitosan, applications of chitosan, chitosan in plant disease management, and conclusion. So the question arises, what exactly does chitin and chitosan stand for? Chitin is one of the most important component of a bacterial cell wall, crustacean cells, and exoskeletons of insect. It is a natural linear biopolymer, which is biodegradable, non-toxic, and eco-friendly in nature. It is one of the most abundant biopolymer after cellulose. As far as the history is concerned, the chitin was isolated from mushroom by a scientist named Henry Breconaud in the year 1811. Later in the year 1859, Rau discovered a derivative of chitosan. The structure of chitin and chitosan were discovered by X-ray diffraction method, infrared spectrum, and enzymatic analysis method in the year 1950. What is chitin? Chitin is a long chain polymer which is composed of N acetyl glucose amine units, which is linked to a bond called beta-1,4 glycosidic linkage. This is the structure where two units of N acetyl glucose amine are linked through the glycosidic bond. Chitosan is a deacetylated product of chitin, which is also a linear biopolymer. The difference being is that there are the units of N-acetylglucosamine as well as N-glucosamine due to deacetylation. The process of deacetylation is done through a chemical called ammonium hydroxide, where the deacetylation of acetyl group is removed and ammonia group is added. The applications of chitosan can be seen in various units such as pharmaceuticals, pharmacognosy, agriculture, and commercial units. In pharmaceuticals company, it is used as a diluent, as a wetting agent, as a slow-release drug, preparation of hydrogels, and as a site-specific drug delivery system. In pharmacognosy, due to its antibacterial, antifungal, and antiviral agent, it is used in various drugs. It is also used as immunostimulant and antioxidant. In agricultural application, it is used as a biopesticide against various pathogens such as fungi, bacteria, viruses, etc. It is also used as a growth promoter and in improving the keeping quality of horticultural produce. It helps in increasing the shelf life of vegetables as well as fruits. In commercial application, it is used in water filtration, used as an agent in cosmetics, in food preservation, as well as in chitosan. It imparts management by using various modes of action. These modes of action includes direct toxicity as well as elicitation of plant defense responses. Under direct drug toxicity, it acts on the membrane and DNA of the pathogen. It also chelates with the metal and helps on the deposition of microbial surfaces. In elicitation of plant defense response, it helps in the production of various pathogen-related proteins and defense-related enzymes. Under direct toxicity, the first mode of action is electrostatic interaction and membrane damage. Chitosan is a polycationic compound which is due to various reactive amino group. It bears a positive charge. When the positively charged chitosan interacts with the negatively charged surface of the pathogen, various interaction between them takes place. This leads to various changes in the surface of the pathogen. This leads to the leakage of intracellular components of the pathogen out of the cell membrane, and this leads to the death of the pathogen. It also acts on the DNA or RNA of the pathogen. Chitosan is a low molecular compound due to which it is able to pass through the cell wall of the pathogen. It reacts with the genetic material such as the phosphate group of DNA and RNA, which ultimately leads to the inhibition of production of protein and later to reproduction. It leads to the death of the pathogen. Under metal chelation, it chelates with various essential nutrients, metal ions, trace elements, which are necessary for the growth and reproduction of the microbes. It creates a competitive situation for the pathogen, which ultimately leads to its disadvantage. Deposition on microbial substances. The chitosan is able to deposit on the microbial substance surfaces. This leads to thickening of the cell wall, and finally the micronutrients or the essential nutrients which are helpful for the growth and development of the pathogen are not able to enter or exit out of the cell wall. This also creates a disadvantage condition for the pathogen. The picture indicates how chitosan acts on the DNA as well as metal chelation, hydrolysis of peptide disruption occurs, which are toxic to the pathogen. Elicitation of plant defense response. Induction of PR protein. Chitin is an efficient inducer of PR protein, namely chitinase and beta glucanase in plants. Chitinase and beta glucanase both acts on hydrogen peroxide and leads to its decomposition into water and hydrogen. Hydrogen peroxide is a toxic compound which is not useful for the plant. So whenever a chitosan acts on the plant, these hydrogen peroxide molecules will be broken down into smaller units, and thus it will help in creating an advantageous situation for the host plant. Induction of defense related enzymes. Chitosan can induce resistance in host by increasing the activity of several defense related enzymes such as PAL, phenyl alanine lyase, peroxidase enzyme, polyphenol peroxidase enzyme, and catalase enzyme. When the skin tape is sprayed with 1% solution of, there was observed that the PAL activity was 2 times higher than untreated control, while the peroxidase activity in the flesh of pure food was significantly increased when it was treated with chitosan. The following slides indicates how chitosan will be beneficial for the host plant against various plant pathogens such as fungi, bacteria, viruses, etc. Chitosan is effective against many fungal agents. It can be used as seed treatment, foliar spray, and soil drench against various pathogens which are soil-borne, seed-borne, and air-borne. It is generally applied at the rate of 1 mg per ml of water as foliar spray and soil drench. It can also be used with various biocontrol agents as a consortium, since it is compatible with all of them. Under this, the following case study, it was observed that when chitosan was applied as a triple combination with copper, chitosan, and trichoderma, it was observed that disease severity was least as compared to control. This table also indicates that a single product as well as dual combination of the product when applied, it was comparatively less effective as compared to the triple combination. The disease severity was comparatively higher. As for the conclusion, we can say that the triple combination of chitosan with copper and trichoderma could be recommended in alternative to chemical pesticides and insecticides as well as fungicides, because it is comparatively more effective than single treatment. The following table indicates how chitosan is effective against fungal pathogens such as Spirocollaria griesia causing blast in rice, Rhizoctonia solanae causing sheath blight in rice, Phytophthora infestans causing late blight in potato, Fusarium oxysporum, former species Lycopersici causing Fusarium wilt in tomato, Alternaria alternata causing early blight in tomato, Sclerotium rolfsi causing stem rot of tomato, Phytophthora palmivora causing leaf fall of rubber, Sclerotinia sclerotiorum causing Sclerotinia rot of carrot, and Colletotrichum abscessi causing anthracnose in chili. Chitosan is also effective in various post-harvest diseases. It is due to its ability to form a film around the surface of the fruits and vegetables. It creates a barrier against the pathogenic attack and thus imparts resistance. It also helps in the control of decay of fruits, thus extending the shelf life of fruits. The picture clearly indicates how chitosan treatment is helpful in inhibiting the growth of Penicillium digitatum, which causes citrus green mold. The first picture is in vitro study of post-harvest treatment of chitosan. It clearly indicates the radial growth of pathogen is comparatively lower in as the concentration of chitosan is increasing. In the second picture, it is shown the in vivo study of chitosan treatment. It shows as the concentration of chitosan is increasing, the disease incidence is decreasing drastically. So we can say that post-harvest treatment of chitosan is effective in controlling Penicillium digitatum. Chitosan is effective against various post-harvest diseases such as fungal rot of strawberry, tomato, and grapes caused by Botrytis cinerea and blue mold of apple and tomato caused by Penicillium expansum. Chitosan is also effective against bacterial pathogen. It is antibacterial in nature due to its bacteriostatic properties. The antibacterial efficacy of chitosan against gram-positive and gram-negative bacteria is somewhat controversial. The reason behind is that scientists believe that the gram-negative bacteria have a thicker cell wall, due to which chitosan is not able to penetrate, thus it is not effective against them. Group of researchers believe that the gram-positive bacteria cell wall is the gram-negative bacterial cell wall is consists of phospholipids and lipopolysaccharides. These imparts overall negative charge to the bacteria. So when polycationic chitosan interacts with the gram-negative bacterial cell wall, it will create some interaction between them, thus leading to the leakage of intracellular particles and molecules. These are the following bacterial pathogens which could be controlled through chitosan treatment. Ralstonia solanacearum causing wilt of tomato, Xanthomonas desiccatoria causing bacterial spot of tomato, Pseudomonas syringae causing bacterial spike of tomato, Irvinia carotovora causing soft rot of potato, Streptomycin scabies causing scab of potato, Pseudomonas lacrimans causing angular leaf spot of cucumber, and Xanthomonas axonopodis causing leaf fall of Poinsettia. Viral pathogens. Chitosan is also effective against various viral pathogens due to its antiviral effect. It helps in the inhibition of replication and systemic multiplication of the viral particle in the host plant, thus imparting resistance. The following case study clearly indicates that when chitosan was treated combined with Pseudomonas fluorescens strain, more disease control was imparted and less disease severity could be observed as compared to the single and dual combinations of Pseudomonas fluorescens. The following viral pathogen could be controlled using the treatment of chitosan, such as tobacco mosaic virus, tobacco necrosis virus, peanut stunt virus, tobacco leaf curl virus, tomato yellow leaf virus, and cucumber mosaic virus. Conclusion. In this era of chemical degradation, scientists are searching for better alternatives for the control of plant diseases in this era. So here the role of chitosan could be observed since it is safe, eco-friendly, biodegradable, and non-toxic to user as well as environment. Also, it could be used with various biocontrol agents due to its compatibility.